Hello everyone, I welcome you to my course Introduction to Computers. I'm Dr. Mazhar Ali and I'll discuss the topic Database Management Systems to you today in this lecture. So database is an organized collection of structured information or data typically stored electronically in a computer system. Since the database management system, or commonly called the DBMS, refers to the technology solution used to optimize and manage the storage and retrieval of the data from databases. Therefore, DBMS, or database management system, offers a systematic approach to manage databases via an interface for users as well as workloads accessing the database via different applications. So in this way, we may say a database is usually controlled by a database management system. So we will discuss the database management system in coming slides. A database management system is a software package designed to define, or manipulate, or retrieve and manage data in the databases. Means what type of the data is available in the database that is defined, manipulated, retrieved, and managed by the DBMS. So a DBMS generally manipulates the data itself, the data format, field names, record structure, and file structure. And it also defines the rules to validate and manipulate the data, what is available in the databases. So database management system provides a solution for storing large amounts of data in an organized way, or in a relational way. Why in a relational way? We will discuss in this lecture today, because different files and entities are related with each other in a database systems. And database management system provide, as I told you, the solution. And it is also when all the tables of database systems are related with each other on different keys, which we will discuss in the coming slides. So it is called the relational database management system. So RDBMS basically organizes the data into tables. And DBMS tables are organized like other tables that you are used to. Means what type of the tables you are generating in the MS Excel or in MS Word and so on. Means you are generating the columns and rows as per your requirements. So database tables are like also the tables in which are generated or created in the MS Word or Excel. And DBMS basically, it is a primarily a software system that can be considered as a management console or an interface to interact with and manage databases. So the interfacing also spreads across real world physical systems that contribute data to the backend databases. The OS, we discussed in the previous lecture, so the OS means the operating system and network software and the hardware infrastructures is involved in creating, accessing, managing, and processing the databases. Therefore, database is stored a large collection of the database, and it controls the different databases or the data available in the databases, as well as it organizes the data. So it becomes a data storage system. Now, the database, as we discussed, is the structured sort of the organized collection and structure of structured information. So we store the data into database. Therefore, database comes after the data. So the data is a collection of a distinct unit of information. The data is used in a variety of forms of text, numbers, media, and many more. So talking in terms of computing, data is basically graphics, figures that can be translated into a particular form for efficient movement and processing. Means when we enter data in database in the fields of database, at that time it is a raw raw data. But when it completes and comes in form of the record, then it's structured and organized. And that form of the data means a structured and organized form of the data is called information. So a database is in, as I told you, is an organized collection of structured data to make it easily accessible, manageable, and update as well. So in simple words, you can say a database in a place where the data is stored. For example, I give you an example, or in you may say in a layman terms, consider your school registry. All the details of the students are entered into a single file, and you get the details regarding the students in that file. So this is called a database where you can access the information of any student. Means when you go to get admission in any school or college or any university, you are asked to provide the basic information, means your personal information, your academic information, your guardian's information, that all information is written or stored in a file. So that file is an example of the database. Means we store or input the all the concerned information. Means all the information should be related with each other. All the fields should be related with each other. And then all the records should be related with each other. It does not, for example, the university is organizing the data or storing the data of the first semester student in a database. So that database will be of the first semester students. Therefore, all the data will be related, all the data of the students will be related in that database. And all the record presents the information of single students. So that will be related to that student only, not to the other students. This is the different, the database store the data in some related form, like in a file. For example, you are making a file of your document, so you will keep your all academic document in that file. And for example, you are in a job, so you will make another file for your job documents. Even you will categorize the different files of your job data. So means each file will be separated. Each file will show your the category of your function. So that is the example of the database. Therefore, a database is a data structure that stores organized information. Most databases contains multiple tables which may each include several different fields. For example, a company database may include tables for products, employees, and financial records. Now, for each product, the file will be, a database will be different, a file will be different. So a database have evolved dramatically since their inception in the early 1960s. Some navigational databases such as the hierarchical databases and the network databases were the original systems used to store and manipulate in the manipulate the different type of the data. Therefore, the main purpose of the data is to store a collection of related items, as I give you, for example. As I told you, you are storing the information of a single product. So in the record, you will input the all the required data information of that product. And it is a collection of, and it will be arranged in some specific structures. So it helps the user or the concerned person, that those all concerned person may get the information in a single record. And there are several types of the databases. So like the relational databases, cloud databases, graphical databases, image databases, several types of the databases are here. But the main, there are two different types, which are the fillet type databases and relational databases. So these are the basic databases. From which other databases are created or generated. So we will discuss these both types in coming slides. So look at this table. This shows the example of the database. If you look here, this is a database. So this is a field. This is a field which is shown to you in the form of column. These are all fields. So first name, last name, company, address, city, state, postal code, and registration, and so on. So different types of the fields or columns are here. These all fields are related to each other. For example, freight, all the data of the freight is available in this record. So as I told you, that one row is a card, basically record. So this row is a card, the record. 1 minute, I'll show you. So this row is a card, record. And this is a field name. These all are the fields. And one row is a called record. Basically, record is the combination of interrelated fields. And field is the basic unit of the database where we store the data. And when these fields are related with each other, but all fields should be related. You cannot relate the data of a robin with freight. So if you will go through this record of the Jim or freight or robin or so on, you will get the data of Jim in this row, or you will get the data of freight in this row. You cannot get any data of a robin or Don or other people in this row. So database give you the a specific and it's separate record of each product or object. So the basic unit of the database is a field that holds the individual piece of data, that store the individual piece of the data, as you saw here. So this is the field where this field stores or hold the data of this object or this person, that is the freight. So this field is the freight, and this is the Jones. Jones is basically related to this field, not to the this field, but to the this field. So field is a basically basic unit of database which hold an individual piece of data. That may be any data, that may be number, that may be the text, that may be image, or that may be anything. And mostly it is called the column. If you see, this is the attribute or column. This is a column. Fields are shown to you in columns, and records are shown to you in rows. So mostly it is called a column. You are different phones, for example, phone book. So there will be the name, address, email, phone number of the person. So each record will be connected to a single person. There may be thousands of the records, lakhs, millions, billions of the records. Therefore, field is a basic unit of the database. You have to remember when you create the data, when you generate the data, you have to generate the fields. And when the data will be inputted in the fields, then that field will make a record. So there may be several various records in a single database. Now, fields, as I told you, the combination of related fields makes a record. So record is a one full set of the fields, but there's a term that fields should be related with each other. So a record is a one instance of a set of fields in a table. So to visualize this, think of the records as the rows of the table and the fields as of the tables, as I show to you in this field. For example, these all are the fields which are connected or related with each other and shown to you in a record. So record is a basically combination of the fields which are interrelated with each other, which are interrelated. All the records are in a single all the fields in a single record are interrelated. So record show you the information of a single object. For example, you have created a database of the phone book. So there will be the Smith, Joe, and 123, some street, and this is a phone number, and so on. So you may generate a database of your own requirement. And a database may have unlimited rows. So rows are basically records. Therefore, a record is a row of a database, as you saw here. A record is a row of a database. So this is the database, a single database, and this record is a single row of this database. A horizontal, and if you look here, it is a horizontal, not vertical. Fields are always vertical and rows are always horizontal. So it's a horizontal groups of fields, interrelated fields. The content of those fields is unique to the that row. Definitely, if you show in this record, all the content available in this row is unique than the others. This record shows the information about the Jim Collins. And this is about John. So all the content is unique in each row. So in the phone book example, for example, if we look here in the phone book example, a record is often used in, if you look here, all the data you find here, they're different than the others, even in this. So our data is definitely looks the different. Therefore, even if you look here in the phone book example, so each last name begins a record or row which contains data in the name, address, and phone number fields. So a record is often used in a database search because each record has a unique identifying quality or value, as I told you. And a database record is basically a row that contains unique data in each of the field. So a database will usually contain a large number of records, but only a small number of fields. And the collection of the interrelated records makes the table. Keep in mind, the collection of interrelated fields make the record, the collection of interrelated fields make the record. Interrelated fields means all the fields are concerned with the single object. So collection of the interrelated fields make the record, and collection of the interrelated records means all the records should be in same format makes the table. For example, this is a phone book table, so it shows the user ID, first name of the user, last name of the user, email, in the phone. So you will not find any other data than the email and phone of the people or any person. Neither there will you not find their other problems or other information. But only this table is generated for the information of emails and phones of people. Therefore, table is a collection of interrelated records. So a table, we may define the table. A table, as I told you, a collection of related data held in a table format. So there must be the table format. So if you look at this table, you feel it like when you like the table in the MS Word or in MS Excel. And it consists of columns. If you look here, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5. So all these tables are consisted of columns and rows. These are the rows, 1 row, 2 row, 3 row, 4, and 5 rows. There are 5 rows and 5 columns in this single table. Therefore, a table has a specified number of columns, but can have any number of rows. Here, the columns are 5 in this table, which may not be extended at this stage. However, they may be, for example, there are 5 records in this table at this stage, but they may be the thousands records, the millions of the records. So the records are not records may not be confined. However, so when you generate the table, you must think that how many columns or attributes should be there in the table, because then those columns will be fixed. However, records are not fixed. You may add it any time. So a database table is composed of records and records and the fields that hold data. So this table, if you look here, the records of the table holds the data. That data is of the for telephone, phone, and email information. The data consists the email and phones, phone numbers. So tables are so-called data sheets. Like in Excel, you see data sheets are like the tables. And each table in a database holds data about a different but related subject. This is a very necessary that all data should be related in a table or in a field or in a record. Now this is the form. In a database context, a form is a window or a screen that contains numerous fields or spaces to enter data. Each field holds a field label so that any user who views the form get an idea of its content. A form is a more user-friendly than generating queries to create tables and insert data into field. Therefore, a database form is a window with the information fields that help gather information to be stored in a database or trigger a process. So all relational database systems worth their salt, like Microsoft Access, etc., include the ability to create and customize database forms. So if you look here, basically this is the table. If you look here, this is a table, but in this form you have to insert the data through queries. But if you are creating a form like this, so you will just enter the data like in Excel or in other softwares. You insert the data. So form provide you platform or make you easy to enter the data in a table. So behind this form there is a database table. So when we enter this data, it is stored in the table. So form present one record to the user at a time. So this is a single record of Nancy, which is shown to you through this form. Even you may show several records in a single form. So it depends on your query, that what type of the query are you executing. And this is the report. So as I told you, in the form, single record is shown to you. This is, if you look here, this is a single record. But in the report, you may get several or various records. So a database report is the formatted result of a database queries and contains useful data for decision making and analysis. Most good business applications contain a built-in reporting tool. So this is simply a front-end interface that calls or run back-end database queries that are formatted for easy application uses. So we definitely run the queries or execute the queries to generate the report. So what type of the data we have required, what type of the records we have required, or how many columns we have required, we have to mention in the query for generating any report. So a report presents data in an attractive format and is especially suitable for printing. Therefore, reports can display data from tables or queries. All our selected fields can be included in a report. So data can be grouped or sorted and arranged in a variety of ways. As I told you, for example, there are 20 columns of the table, but you required only these 5 columns. So you will skip the other 15 columns and generate a query that will show you only these 5 columns in the report, because you need this type of the data in a report. So you may get the data according to your requirement in the reports. So this make you very easy and provide you data in a printing form as well, because when report is generated, you may make the PDF of that report, as well as you may get the print in hard copy. So as we discussed earlier, that there are two major type of the database, though there are several types of the database, but basically, it is divided into two types. One is a flat file database. Second is a relational database management system. So, The FLAT file database is a database that stores data in a plain text file. So each line of the text file holds one record with the fields separated by delimiters, such as the commas or tabs, or even in this form of the table. While it uses a simple structure, a FLAT database cannot contain multiple tables like in a relational database. So this is a simple database. Means it is for the single person or single object. These tables cannot be connected with the other databases or other tables. Therefore, useful for simple data storage. And very means you may know the information about a single person or any object. And when you are generating a database for a single person, you may generate such type of the database, because these databases are not connected. Though you may enter several records in this database, but this database cannot be connected with other databases, or this table cannot be connected with other databases. However, this may be connected when you make it the part of the relational database. So this is the difference between the relational and FLAT file databases. FLAT file database is for a single purpose, means it generates a table for a single purpose. It is not it may not be useful for the multiple purposes where you link the files. In the relational database, if you here the data presents the table presents the patient ID, name, date of birth, gender, phone, doctor, and doctor room. But if you connect other tables with this, like the ward or a room and the hospital and the emergency and medicine and so on, then it will be a relational database. But if you get only the basic information of patient or any employee or any object, then the FLAT file databases are very good. So in this, a single table is generated where several records may be entered. But relational database, as I told you, it is a different, because a relational database is a type of a database. It uses a structure that allows us to identify and access data in a relation to another piece of data in the databases. So often data in a relational database is organized into a tables. Databases can be organized in many different ways and thus take many forms. The most popular form of a database today is the relational database. So popular examples of relational databases are Microsoft Access, MySQL or MySQL, and Oracle. So a relational database is the one in which data is organized into one or more tables, as I told you while discussing the FLAT file databases. So each table has a set of fields which define the nature of the data stored in the table. In the early 1980s, a relational database became very popular, which was followed by object-oriented database later. So RDBMS, or Relational Database Management System, is the basis for SQL or SQL and for all modern database systems like MS SQL Server, IBM DB2, Oracle, MySQL, and Microsoft Access. So a relational database management system is a database management system that is based on the relational model, a relational model was introduced by EF Code. So in a relational database, all the tables are related by one or more fields, so that it is possible to connect all the tables in the database through the fields they have in a common. For each table, one of the fields is identified as a primary key. As I told you in this slide, if you connect this table with others, for example, this table is a part of a relational database, then this attribute of a column will be make as a primary key. Then we may connect this record with the other tables. So this key is the unique identifier for each record in the table. And to help you understand these terms further, You may even make the tables in this. For example, this table, assume this table is a part of the relational database. So we will make this table the primary key. So this will be the unique key. Means 134 number will be allotted only for this patient, and we will identify all other things of this patient on basis of this key. Means for example, medicine, doctor's name is here. However, the hospital name, the ward or the room, and all the other related things may be found on basis of this key. So in a relational database, all the as I told you, all the tables are related with each other, and minimum there should be two tables in a relational database. If it is a single table, then it will be called the FLAT 5 database. But if there are more than one table, then in the single database, then it will be called the relational database. So what happened in this database, all the tables are related by a common field called a relationship or a join, and that common field is a basically primary key, which is a reference to other tables, which may be which is a reference to other key. So here it is a primary key, and in other table this will be the reference key. So most common form of a database, it is a nowadays organizations are using the relational database. ER model. ER means entity relation. So for real relational database management system, we are using the ER model, or we call it the ER diagram. So in the entity relationship model, describes interrelated things of interest in a specific domain of knowledge. A basic ER model or basic entity relationship model is a composed of entity types and specifies relationships that can exist between entities. So in ER diagram, if you look here, this is the ER diagram. It shows the relationship among entities sets. An entity set is a group of similar entities, as we discussed already. So this is a single entity of the student, and this is the college where that student studies. That's why an entity set is a group of similar entities, and these entities can have attributes. Like this entity means the table of the database. So this entity has three attributes, and this entity has two attributes. So in terms of DBMS or database management system, an entity is a table, or the attributes of a table in the database. So by showing a relationship among tables and their attributes, the ER diagram shows the complete logical structure of database. So if you look here, this is a entity, a table that have three attributes. One is a student ID, student name, and student address. And here college ID and the college name. So these both tables are connected with each other through study in. Means the primary key is connected with the primary key is this table is connected on the reference of this key, because the college information will be shown to you of this student. So that information will be collected on basis of the student ID. So ER model shows you the logical structure of the database, relational database, that how database is related with each other, or how the entities of database are related with each other. So when we are working with the database, so definitely we create the tables, or we generate the tables, and then we generate different type of the tables. So when we plan to generate any table, we must write or think. But to write is a better way, because documentation make you proper. So when, for example, you are going to generate any entity for your business, for your client, for anything, you must list the necessary field, that how many fields should be there in your entity. For example, you are generating the telephone directory, then you have to write down the field, that how many fields should be there. And then, because after this, you will be clear that how many columns will be generated, and then you will generate the table. So there are two ways. So if you are using the MS Access, the MS Access provide you the visual access, means you write the entity name or field name and give the status, either that is the serial number. So you may take the auto number or manual if you want that the serial number comes automatically, then show the data type. So variable other data type is auto number. And if you want to continue your database by entering the manual, then you should not take the auto number. Then by first name, now what is the first name? The definitely name should be in a text, and the last name definitely should be text, and date created or phone number. If you are entering the date, then take the data type, date and time. But if you are writing here the phone number, so there should be then the number, because you will not enter any text. But if you are entering the phone number in form of a string, then you should take the string. So MS Access provide you platform to generate database even in a visual form. But if you are using the SQL or SQL, then you have to run the queries for the create table. So you may name any named of the table, and like the name should be, this is the variable, the data type, and these are the field names, and these are the data types. And if you are making this table for the relational database, then make any your table field or column as a primary key. So you may generate the query, the table in these two forms for the database. So when we are generating the table, definitely we define the fields. So fields may be of different type. It describes the type of the data where your data will be stored. So most DBMS use the same types as I shown to you, the text data type, or the new, either your data may be in a textual form or in a numerical field, or you may use the date and time, or you may use some logical fields like the yes or no, or we may call it the Boolean as well. If you are using the Boolean, yes or no, even the binary or counter field or any other field may use. So there are several fields like the text, date, numerical, yes, no, drop down even. So different fields are here which you may use to generate the table. When you are generating the table, you must keep the field's name in your mind, that which I have to select the fields. Because for example, you are generating 10 attributes of columns of table, means you are generating 10 fields of your table. So you definitely 10 fields will be present the information of any object. So you have to keep the names, remember the names of fields. Either they will be text, either they will be a numerical, either they will be yes, no, or either they will be the drop down. You may keep the data into drop down as well, or memos or binaries and so on. So these fields, definitely when we generate any field or create any field, we must have to give the data type, that what type of the data will be inserted or stored in that field. So this is a necessary. All the data will be inserted according to their data type. You may not insert the data, textual data, into number and numbers. You may not. So you have to select the fields. However, you may insert the numbers and the text into strings or the into text file. So these are some different of the fields which you have to understand and remember. And after the creation of the table, when table is created, then we will definitely insert the data. Means we will enter the data into table which is created for any purpose. So users type data into a field. We insert the data into field. If you look here, so this data is inserted into field. field, that is the first name, and this is the last name. So all the data is entered in the fields. A type of the data is here. So this for example table is created into the MS Access. So in the MS Access you may insert data because it provide you visual platform. But if you are using the any SQL, you have to or Oracle, you have to insert the data by generating by executing the query. So tables are basically generated to enter the data. So we enter the data in the table. Which is related to us object. For example, you are entering data of any product. So in a single record, there may be several fields in a single record, but you will insert the data of that object in a single record. And the first step is to generate the create the table. Second step is to enter the data. Third step, definitely why we enter the data into table. Definitely we want to view the data at, when we have required, when our boss want to see our work, when any because any reason for viewing the data, there may be any reason. So when organization or even ourselves or any person or any related person want to see the data, view the record, that may be view the record by inserting the executing the query, or even if you have keep some facilities in your database, the people may see the data. As we see the data of different products and different websites, so there is a basically database behind those product websites. So we may or any one may view the data. So data sheet views shows all records in form of a report on a data sheet. We show the records, and even we may filter, as I told you earlier, that for example there are 20 attributes or columns of your database, but you want to show only 5 columns, you may show, means you may filter or you may take the attributes according to your requirements. So is however the form will facilitate you in showing the single record at a time, and the reports may show you various records at a time. So it depend on the organization or the person, either they want to view the record as single or in a multiple form. So if you want to view the records into multiple forms, or you want to multiple records in a single report, you should show the report. And if you want to view the record as a single, then you should use the form. And then sorting record, definitely record may be up or in a down sizes, or means there may be different positions or locations of the record. So to sort the record means to order the records based on the field. For example, sometimes we generate we create several columns in a table. But when we show the data, when we view the data, we are not taking all the records, but we sort the records as per our requirement. Though all fields are required, but sometimes we will not show all records to the clients or customers. There may be some problems, but organization sometimes organization wants only the 5 attributes, the basic information of the employee. Sometimes organization wants whole information or a whole record of the employees. Therefore, we have to sort the record. So the record may be sorted alphabetically, numerically, chronologically, in ascending form, in a descending form. It depends on us that either we want to view the records alphabetical, means first A, B, C, and so on, or in ascending or in a descending, so it, or in the serial number, or in other way. It depends on the organization or the person or the customer. So in what form or in what type of the data they want to see. So according to their requirement, the data is sorted or filtered. Querying a data is definitely it is a statement that describes the desired data. Means you want to query a data, is for example, you want to view the data. So you will query the data as I show you before. For example, this is entering. So like this, we view the data. So definitely for that purpose, we query. So it is a statement that describes the desired data, that what type of the data we want to see or view. So we have to define the list of fields. Or even, for example, we want to modify the record, then also we will make some query. So query may be used for inserting, viewing, modifying, sorting, and anything. If you want to find the data, for example, search the data, even you want to calculate different values per record, or if you want to delete the record, or sort the record, or view the record, or enter the data in the record, you will use any database query. So it is a very much important for a database developer, or that person who uses the database or who generates the database, they must remember the queries and their formats or their structures. So all the there are different query languages, and all the database management systems use a query language. And so the most popular relational database query language is SQL, means structured query language. Some people call it SQL. It is created by IBM in 1974. Many types of SQL exist, including MySQL, PostgreSQL, PLSQL, means procedural language SQL. It is used by the Oracle. TSQL, and several types of the SQLs are here, Microsoft SQL and so on. So SQL is a domain-specific language used in a programming and designed for managing data held in a relational database management system, or for stream processing in a relational data streams management system. And it is a particularly useful in handling structured data, that is the data incorporation, relations among different entities and variables. So SQL was one of the first commercial language to utilize EF, quotes, relational model, because SQL is working on the relational database management system, and the relational database system management system is developed on basis of EF, quotes, relational model. So it is originally based upon relational algebra and tuple relational calculus. So SQL consists of many types of statements, which may be informally classed as sublanguages, or commonly data query language, most commonly called the DQL, or a data definition language, DDL, or a data control language, DCL, and a data manipulation language, DML. So these are queries are used by the SQL, which are used to manipulate or the manipulation of any database table. So the scope of SQL includes data query or data manipulation, and means insert, update, and delete the data records in a table, or the data definition, like the schema creation and the modification, and the data access control as well. So different, these all things are used in the SQL. As I told you, it is the most common query language of different databases. Another is the XBase. So XBase is the XBase is also query language. It is the generic term for all programming languages that derive from the original DBase programming languages and database formats. So it's a generic programming language. And query, by example, QB, it is an interface to SQL or XBase. So interactive query design, definitely. So query, by example, is a basically database query language for relational databases. It was devised by Moshe M. Zeloff at IBM Research during the mid-1970s. In parallel to the development of SQL. So it is the first graphical query language using visual tables where the user would enter commands, for example, elements and conditions. So QB, by example, or QBE, commonly the database programmers call it the QB, or database designer call it the QB, is a query method implemented in the most database systems, most notably for relational databases. So QB was created by Moshe Zeloff, as I told you. And mostly people are using it for graphical and other things. Now, when we use any database, definitely we need the reports. We may view the data in forms, but for different organizations, business organizations, we need the report. For example, you have hundreds of employees, thousands of employees, or you have various type of the partners. So you will not view each form easily. So a boss or organization needs some data reports. So a report generator is used. So report generator is a computer program whose purpose is to take data from a source such as a database, XML stream, or a spreadsheet, and used to produce a document in format that satisfies a particular human readership. So it can also be asked that a report generation is a part of the purpose of spreadsheets, because we get the complete information in a single report, and the printed information definitely in form of printed information that is extracted from the database. As I told you, if you want to get information, if you are running a business and you have various type of the partners, so you will get a report that is in from the database, and that will be in hard form, hard copy, or in a soft copy. And definitely data may be calculated as per row or per table and so on. Even the pictures and formatting can be included. If you want to see data with the pictures, you may generate the reports with the pictures and different formats as well. And different reporting softwares are here which may be used along with the databases. So when you generate the table and insert the data, it will be easy to see the data in form of reports. Now it depends on the organization that what type of the report format they want. So we discussed the database management systems, relational database management system, the process of creating the table, the process of viewing the table, process of sorting the table, and process of viewing the forms and reports, and different we discussed the different query languages with their historical view. Hope you got it. So we will meet again with the another topic of the introduction to computers. Thank you very much.